brought to you by Gitanjali Salon, Channi Himmat, Jammu. Follow Ruchika Makeovers on Facebook and Instagram for best bridal makeup in town.
Hello viewers, you're watching Jammu Links News. I'm Manat Gupta and welcome to the daily updates of Midday News. Let's begin.
Jammu and Kashmir Lieutenant Governor Girish Chandra Murmu called a Defence Minister Rajnath Singh on Wednesday. The Lieutenant Governor is understood to have briefed the Minister about the current situation in the region. However, no official statement was issued by the government on the meeting. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh is scheduled to visit Ladakh on Friday to take stock of India's military preparedness in the wake of a bitter border standoff with the Chinese troops in the region. To be accompanied by Chief of Army Staff General M.M. Naravane, it will be the Defence Minister's first visit to Ladakh after the standoff between the two armies began on May 5th. The visit is aimed at boosting morale of the army personnel engaged in the 7-week bitter border face-off with the Chinese troops in the region. Zulfikar Hassan, ADG, Central Reserve Police Force, on Thursday said that the allegations that the CRPF took out the civilian from the car and shot him in untrue and retaliated that he got caught in the firing by terrorists. The ADG further said that there is no question of the involvement of the CRPF in the incident. The firing by the CRPF was restrained so that we do not cause any damage to the mosque. A controversy erupted over Sopor encounter in Jammu and Kashmir after a family member alleged that his relative was killed in firing by the security forces.
So we are very confident of what has happened. I would request the people who are spreading these carnage, they should blame the militant, that the militants are hiding in mosques and trying to, you know, in their great eagerness to kill security forces, they don't care about whether a child is there or an elderly person is there, they just fire. The man, I would say in unequal terms, the man, the unfortunate civilian who died, has been killed by the militants firing from a mosque.
India's COVID-19 tally breached the 6 lakh cases mark with 19,148 new coronavirus cases being reported in the last 24 hours, informed the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare on Thursday. The total cases now stand at 6,04,641, of which there are 2,26,947 active cases, while 3,59,860 patients have been cured or discharged or migrated. 434 deaths have been reported in the last 24 hours, taking the number of COVID-19 deaths in the country to 17,834. The Jammu and Kashmir government has evacuated about 1,77,922 JK residents stranded in other parts of the country due to COVID lockdown via Lakhanpur and through special trains and buses till date amid strict observance of all necessary guidelines and stranded operating procedures. As per the official data received in this regard, the Jammu and Kashmir administration has received 70 special trains at Jammu and Udhampur railway stations from different states and UTs so far, with about 57,054 passengers, while about 1,20,868 persons from other states and UTs, including 657 from abroad, have been evacuated by the government through Lakhanpur till date. Two more COVID-19 positive patients in Jammu and Kashmir died at a hospital in Srinagar on Thursday, taking to 107 the number of coronavirus-related fatalities in the Union Territory. On Wednesday, Jammu and Kashmir has recorded 198 fresh COVID-19 cases, raising the tally in the Union Territory to 7,695. Jammu and Kashmir Lieutenant Governor Girish Chandra Murmu said that the government is making diligent efforts to wean away youths from the vicious circle of terrorism and bring them to the mainstream. The Lieutenant Governor also spelled out the government's plan to launch a campaign to bring back the youth from militancy. In a message to the Kashmiri youths, the LG said, "Vested elements in Pakistan have no love for them and that the objective of these forces is to destabilize India by creating an atmosphere of violence and turbulence." Divisional Commissioner Sanjeev Verma visited Border Tehsil Hiranagar and inspected the progress on under-construction border bunkers and security arrangements put in place along the IB in view of Amarnath Yatra. The Divisional Commissioner directed the executing agencies to expedite the work of bunkers by adding extra men and machinery in the assigned task. He further called upon the engineers to adhere to the quality standard. Commissioner Secretary to Government Manoj Kumar Dwivedi on Wednesday assumed the charge as Commissioner Secretary General Administration Department at Civil Secretariat Jammu. In his maiden interaction with the officers of the GAD, Dwivedi reviewed the urgent and priority issues and called for working with zeal and dedication. While speaking in a program organized by Hotel and Restaurant Association Katra, Basir Ahmed Khan, advisor to Lieutenant Governor, said that the government is preparing SOPs and guidelines for revival of tourism in J&K by taking proper inputs from different quarters. In view of importance of Katra Vaishno Devi Ji, the concrete plan for channelizing 10 million pilgrims and increasing their stay will be made, and much emphasis on Katra is being made, he said. Pakistan on Thursday initiated an unprovoked ceasefire violation along the line of control in the Shahpur and Kirni sector of the Poonch district in Jammu and Kashmir. The Indian Army is retaliating. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo on Wednesday applauded India's ban on 59 Chinese apps, including TikTok and WeChat, and stressed that the move would boost India's integrity and national security. Almost all apps banned by the Indian government have some preferential Chinese interest, and the majority have parent Chinese companies. The World Health Organization has estimated the overall number of coronavirus cases globally at 10 million, with 5 million people having died from the disease. The UN Health Agency said in the situation report published on late Wednesday that 1.6 million new cases have been recorded in the past day, while further 4,188 patients had died. Americas continue to lead the count with over 5.2 million cases, followed by Europe with more than 2.7 million. Oh,